Parental neglect, parental rejection, healing emotional trauma of parental neglect with the movie therapy Whale Rider. Hi guys, my name is Lena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel Psychology of Happiness. If you're new to my channel, welcome and please consider subscribing with hitting the notification bell so you will be notified about all my future self-development videos and guided meditation techniques. Today I would like to talk to you about the deep emotional trauma of parental neglect during childhood. Sometimes this type of emotional wound can be tied to a specific event during childhood. For example, the death of another child or physical illness of one of the parents. But in most cases, parental neglect has its roots deep into a family system. Usually, parental neglect is not a one-time event. Usually, it moves from one generation to another, which makes it even harder to unpack and to heal. Today, I would like to show you how this type of trauma can be developed, how it can be passed from one generation to another, how it affects all members of the family, and most importantly, how it can be healed. For that purpose, I would like to offer you a movie therapy technique, which is one of my favorite psychological methods of healing emotional trauma. The movie that I prepared for you today is called Whale Rider. This movie tells the story of a girl who was rejected by her grandfather simply because she was a girl. Unfortunately, this continues to happen in our modern world as well. When a family is expecting a baby of one gender, they can have a hard time accepting and loving a child of the other gender. You've probably heard stories where parents were cutting a girl's hair very short or teaching their daughter some masculine activities. Some families do not hide the fact that they were expecting a child of a different gender. But they're trying to pretend that they love the child and accept the child for who she is or who he is. Even in the reality, they are rejecting them. The parents' expectations are too high. The child is being raised under the weight of huge criticism, huge limitations, and prohibitions. In this movie, we learn that rejection was not just a one-time event. The girl's father was also rejected and criticized by his father, even though he was a boy. Later in the movie, we learn that the true reason for the rejection was not actually a gender difference, but rather the expectations that the grandfather placed on the children. By watching the movie, we are learning that this is the family trauma that is spreading from one generation to the next. Because of high expectations, the grandfather was not able to see the children's natural skills and talents. The grandfather was expecting his older son to be a leader, but the boy was not interested in leadership. He was an artist. He wanted to be a creator. The younger child was talented in martial arts and might have been a great leader, but the grandfather ignored that quality in him. Same with the girl, the granddaughter. The grandfather was rejecting her skills of the leader just because she was a girl. This movie is called Whale Rider. In the culture and tradition of this family, whales are the symbol of the ancestors, the strong living force that is being transmitted from one generation to another. When the grandfather rejects his son and his daughter, the energy of love cannot flow. We can see the symbolism of this when the grandfather finds whales washed up on the shore. They came to die. Metaphorically, it represents that the family system is falling apart. The energy of love and support cannot exist anymore. Instead of making the family stronger, it's destroying them. Without our family support, without the acceptance of our parents and grandparents, we become weak. The pain of rejection is so deep that it can be comparable to the mourning of a death. The person can become hollow without family support. People can suffer from things like alcohol or drug addictions. People can experience severe depression and anxiety attacks. Without family love and support, it is extremely hard to achieve our goals, create healthy relationships, and follow our dreams. This movie is not only about the family trauma. This movie is also about the healing process. When the love order is restored and the grandfather realizes his mistake, everything comes into place. All family members get together. Abundance and joy are returning to the family. If you feel that you have been rejected, neglected, or misunderstood by your family members, then I highly recommend watching this movie. When you watch it, imagine yourself as Pi, the main character of the movie, the girl, the granddaughter. Even if you are a man, you can still do it. No matter our gender, we all have feelings and emotions. We all can relate to the girl and to her family story. I want you to watch this movie from beginning to end. Try to fully connect with the character. Experience her pain and the healing power of the movie as well. I want you to focus on the feelings of freedom that the girl experiences when she fully takes her place in the family system. This is the moment of healing. This is the moment when she experiences the joy of being who she is and no longer has to fulfill someone else's expectations. Please remember that for the best healing effect, you should turn off your cell phone and watch the movie alone from beginning to end. Try not to eat any snacks during the movie. Try not to bring any drinks or any type of food, because food helps us to suppress our emotions. And here we want the opposite effect. We want to relieve our emotions and release them so they no longer are holding us down. Enjoy your healing moment. You can watch the finale multiple times, reliving it again and again together with the characters. If you have any questions, please write them in the comment section. And please give me a thumbs up if you like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you have any questions, you can write them below in the comment section, or you can send them on my website or on my social media via Facebook or Instagram. I'm looking forward to seeing your likes and your comments. Of course, thank you for watching. My name is Elena Semenek, and this is Psychology of Happiness. Until next time, bye.